Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. This is Misskaykrizz, and today we're going to talk about my ultimate guide on how to be a cabin crew this 2019. So if you're ready to be a cabin crew this 2019, just keep on watching. But before we start, let's do a book shout out. And this one is from all of you guys who bought the book and sent me a photo of it. Okay, this one is from Sheila May Camo. She just had a story saying, got it. Thank you, Misskaykrizz. And ito, this is way back the first launch. It's my first time to give a shout out. This is from Christian. He's already a flight attendant for Qatar Airways. That's the cue. Got it today. Okay. She's so cute. She looks so happy. She does look so happy. Yes. Okay. Thank you so much for supporting the book, Ready for Takeoff. And if you are interested to know more about it, links will be down below. So right now, let's get started to our topic for today, which is my ultimate guide, how to be a cabin crew in 2019. So to be a flight attendant, you have to apply for the position. So the more you apply, the more chances of winning. So we have to be alert on who is hiring, especially here in the Philippines. There are a lot of hiring coming from international airlines. So make sure that you follow them on their social media, those companies that you are interested in, like Qatar Airways, Air Asia, or Emirates, also IPAMS. So I usually send out hiring alerts to my email subscribers on a monthly basis, and my sources, or where do I get the information who is hiring, is on these links that I have posted on the blog post. It's ipams.com, it's workabroad.ph, careers.jgsummit.ph, philippineairlines.com/about-us/career-opportunities, and careers.qatarairways.com. So that's where I got, or I get everything, all the information of who is hiring nowadays. And also, it wouldn't hurt to follow vlogs, blogs like Fly High Manila and Misskaykrizz, and also the flygosh.com. He covers everyone who is hiring around the Asia Pacific region. I will also put the links here on the description box if you want to see, or if you want to know where I get my hiring alerts from, so that you could check them out as well. So the more you are aware on who is hiring, the more chances that you can get the job. Okay, so my next tip for you, or next guide for you, is to be savvy on your online application. It's now 2019, guys. It's not the same as when I was applying way back 2014. That is 5 years ago. Okay, so way back then, it was just only starting out the online application, but now it is heavily practiced among big airline companies out there because of the massive amount of applicants that they get. It just makes sense for them to digitize even the application process. So usually nowadays, if you want to apply, for example, Fly Dubai or Qatar or Etihad, they would want you to go through their online application first. So first you have to go to their website and apply from there. And if on the website you pass, they will send you an email with an appointment on where you could attend in-person interview. So these are the types of open days where it is only for invited applicants only. Okay, so how do we become savvy in online application? I have a few tips. The first one is you have to be ready. You have to be ready on your application online. So when you're sitting there in front of your computer, make sure that you already have your pictures professionally taken. You have your CV in a digital format as well as a digitized format of your passport. Usually, airlines also require that the applicants have a passport, so you have to send these documents to them. And if you haven't gotten your passport yet, make sure that you get yourself passport. So also during these online applications, you will have to answer different interview questions already. Aside from sending in your CV and your pictures, you have to answer questions like, why do you want to hire from me? Why do you want to work for us? Why do you want to be a cabin crew? What do you think are your qualities that makes you the best suited candidate for the position, and questions like that. So it's more of an essay like type of questions that you're gonna have to go through, and sometimes they also incorporate exams during this online application, so you have to be ready. There will be like English exams and math problems during this selection process. Other airlines, after you past your online application, they will book you for a Skype interview, like for example Fly Dubai. That is their standard procedure, so they will interview you using Skype only. So you have to be prepared, like for example, even though if it's not in person, you still have to put on full makeup, make your nails done and your hair done, and also wear a business attire for an interview appropriate outfit for the day, even at least just the top side of your outfit. And also make sure that you communicate in straight English, okay? So because it's also an interview, just because you are on a video call doesn't mean it makes it casual. It's still an interview, even if you are just, you know, talking through the monitor. Okay, so yeah, and then usually after they have screened you through the online application and the online face-to-face interview, you still have to go to the next level, which is the in-person interview. So my tip number three is to be ready for a face-to-face interview, you know, a live in-person interview. Few tips that I have for you is, have your bare minimums ready. What do I mean by bare minimums? This is your pictures, your CV or resume, your shoes, your outfit, your makeup, your hair, okay, your nails, okay? So these are the things that is just bare minimum that you really need to prepare to be ready for the interview. But the problem that I most encounter with my students or with myself before, even myself or my friends when we were applying before, we spend all of our preparation time on the bare minimums, that we don't have enough time to prepare ourselves in different ways, okay? So if you have read my book Ready for Takeoff, there I have talked about the different ways that you could prepare for your interview, not just the bare minimums, because if you just focus on the bare minimums, you will automatically be drowning in a sea of other applicants who is much more prepared in other areas than you. So don't spend too much time on finding the perfect outfit or making sure that you take out all your pimples and doing your perfect makeup. Instead, you have a lot of other things to prepare for, and that's what we're going to talk about on this third point, which is get ready for the application in person. The next thing, you have to prepare physically. That means your body posture and your communication skills. You have to practice talking to a mirror. You have to practice, you know, walking in a room, sitting, and when you are speaking, your body language also says a lot about you. So aside from, you know, your outfit and your makeup, you also have to practice your English. Another preparation that you need to do when you are going to apply in person is your mental preparation. Like I said, I've mentioned this on my book, you have to prepare or anticipate the type of questions that they will ask you in person. It probably is the same questions that you have answered already on their website or on the Skype interview. This time, because you are in person, it's gonna be the same questions and perhaps more when you reach the final levels, you know, the final interview levels. So be ready with an answer. Make sure that you deliver it in a greatest way possible, not in a robotic tone, and as well as be prepared on answering open-ended questions like what is your worst what is the worst thing that happened to your life and how have you overcome it. So you to be ready to apply in person, my last tip is to know what to expect. you can read vlogs, you can watch vlogs, you can see how other people, you know, posted on social media on their experience on how they are flying, so that you just be more psychologically and mentally prepared for the day of the interview. Because you knowing what to expect kind of give you some sort of control of the situation, and then you will have less instances where you are too nervous to function. Okay, so that's my tips for getting ready to apply in person. Okay, so here, after you got ready, now you are already on the recruitment day. So these are my tips for you guys. You have to do deep breaths. Okay, so deep breaths are the only way that could help you calm your nerves. So when you feel nervous, you're feeling like you're shaking and too scared, take a deep breath. Hold it in for 5 seconds and then you exhale slowly. This way you will get your heart rate down, you will have a better chance to answer questions, and then you will look more poised and more, you know, composed among others. All of you are nervous at this time probably, so you will look more put together if you could just get your breathing in control. The next tip I have for you during the interview itself is always remember to have a mantra, and this mantra is eye contact, posture, and smile. Okay, so you always have to remember this thing. So if you go to an impact interview, this is the first thing that they assess from you. Can you give an eye contact? Are you smiling? Do you stand well? Do you have a good first impression to another person? So this is what will help you give a good impression: eye contact, smile, and posture. So this is saying something about you even without you even starting to talk yet. Okay, so yeah, remember the mantra: eye contact, smile, and posture. Okay, all right, so, and then the next tip that I have for you guys who are now on the recruitment day itself: have to stop comparing yourself with the other candidates. This is like your downfall. If you start doing this, you cannot stop. You will go into a downward spiral wherein you just keep on comparing and comparing, and that is not your job. It is actually the job of the recruiter to judge all of you and not you. That's not your job. So leave it out to the recruiter, let them have a headache, and just focus on you. Focus on your deep breathing, focus on your answers, focus on your posture and your smile. That way you will have more clarity, more energy to give out during your turn to get interviewed. Okay, because you might already feel defeated if you keep on comparing yourself way on, you're still on the line, and even before your turn you also already feel like, oh, everybody's better than me. So you will not be in a good mental state if you do that. So just please stop this bad habit, comparing yourself to the other applicants. All right, next thing, you have to say hello to your seatmate. You have to make friends, because the job of a flight attendant is that every day you work with people who are strangers, and you have to be the first one to say, hi, my name is Ruth. Where are you from? What have you been doing before this for this job? So that is also one of the things that the recruitments observe when they pass around. Are you somebody who is just quiet all the time, keeps to himself, or are you someone who socializes among others? So just keep it to a minimum. Keep all the topics professional, and don't gossip too much. Just make sure that, just show that you are someone who can build a rapport to your group mates or your applicant mates on the same day, because sometimes they take into account that type of, you know, behavior, you know, the things that, you know, that they, the things that the recruiter take note of even before, you know, they are judging you. Okay, so when you walk down, even before you talk, and the way you interact with your environment when you are put in a group situation and things like that, so all of this, everything, just remember when you walk into the interview room, everything that you're doing is being observed. So make sure that you do the best that you can. Okay, so yeah, make friends to your seatmates. And now during the interview, so you're done waiting your turn, and now we are going to ask you questions already. The recruiters are going to ask you questions. So these are my tips for you. Remember to smile before speaking, during the pauses of your sentences, and at the end. Very important, always end your answers with a smile. Just like in a beauty pageant contest, okay? Okay, deep breathing again to help you with the nervousness and presence of mind. Don't let your mind wander. So you have to be here at this moment where you are being interviewed. This is the judgment day, okay? This is where they will take note of all of your... So you have to be here. You don't mentally check out. You have to be present. So presence of mind. Alright. So that's just it. You don't have to remember so much because you're already busy during the interview. So those are just the things that I want you to remember. And the last but not the least tip I have for you guys for this ultimate guide on how to be a flight attendant in 2019 is my guide for you after the interview. So after all is said and done, you have to make sure that you add your co-applicants in social media, get their numbers, or add them on Viber, because you want to keep tabs on each other if you hear the results, or maybe you made a friend. Okay, so it's really nice to have a support system when you are waiting for a result, especially for the interviews like this. It could be that you will get sad if some of them gets the job or not, but you gain the friend, and it's gonna be an inspiration for you if you see their post, if they become a flight attendant and you're still waiting for your turn. So it really helped me, at least in my days when some of my co-applicants made it and I didn't. I always like stalk them on social media so that I would see what to expect, you know, things like that. Don't feel bad, don't feel sorry for yourself, because you know there's nothing to be ashamed of. You did your best, and just keep your connections, the ones that you made during this interview. And then aside from that, also don't think that it will happen that way. That's thinking negatively. You have to think positive. Claim it. My second tip for you is to claim the job for yourself. If you keep yourself in that space where you are like, oh my gosh, I got the job, it will definitely happen. You're doing the law of attraction to yourself, and hopefully it works, because it has been working for me all the time in my life. So yeah. The next thing that you can do if you don't believe in the law of attraction and you're a certified Christian, you could pray the novena. Go to Simala if you're from Cebu and just pray for good results on your interview, because that's all that you can do once na it's done. It's kalas, it's finished. If the results are available right away, good and well, but most of the time it's a waiting game. So think of it as a game, and you have to the person who can wait the most, you know, who can wait without going crazy will win. So you could either start a business, or start a vlog, start blogging, start a new hobby, or go to the gym and try to take your mind off it, because it's not for your best interest to stress about it anymore. All right, there you have it, guys. My best, or my ultimate guide on how to be a flight attendant in 2019. I hope you guys learned a lot from this video. And if you want to read the written version of this, it's going to be available on my website. The links are below as well. And yeah, chasing the dream of a flight attendant is not easy as 1, 2, 3. For others, it could be that way, but for most of us, it's not. So don't stress if you don't get in the first try. That is very common, and that is normal. What I can say is that it's gonna be worth it once you already are a flight attendant. You will know what I mean. The travel, the lifestyle, the opportunity that you will get is all there. Alright, if you're watching this video and you still have no idea on how to be a flight attendant this year, you could check out my workshop, which is happening first this year. Okay, my first ever in-person workshop is going to be happening on March 2 in Greenbelt 1, Max's I don't have the time yet, but if you would like to enroll to that workshop, it's going to be focused on the interview success. Okay, it's called the Interview Success Workshop, where it's going to be more focused on how you create your answers, how you deliver it, and there's going to be a lot of work from you guys. You're not gonna be just sitting there and listening to me talk, but I'm going to guide you on how to get you to become your best version of yourself for your interview. So if you're interested in that workshop, I have 30 slots available. If you want to reserve your slot, you could get the ticket right away. So the details will be also in the description box below, and hurry and get yourself reserved, because this is a long-awaited workshop, and finally it's happening, and I'm so excited. So make sure that you reserve your slot, and I will see you there March 2 at Greenbelt 1 Maxis. That's it for this video, guys. Thank you for staying with me, and I will see you in the workshop, hopefully, and fly with you soon. Bye.